meeting was very successful. You were present in Delhi. Very, very successful. All big, big men came and they realized. We are going to have again that for 2 days. That is being arranged.
In Delhi, yeah. That'll be nice.
But who is thinking? We are thinking. Give it power.
On the table?
Yes. बोलिए कुछ जवाब दीजिए Dr. Bora, he can say. The aim should be Sansiddhi Haritosanam. But if you don't care for this proposition, they do not know what is God, neither we don't want to satisfy Him. He may be satisfied or not satisfied. Let us go on with our business. Bolie.
Huh? We'll be putting ourselves into trouble.
Yes, we are in trouble. Even in last war, when the trouble was too much, they began to go to the church. Even Churchill. And one gentleman, he is my godbrother in Germany, he told me after this war, many German men and women became atheists. Everyone went to the church and prayed, especially women prayed for return of their husband, brother, father, and nobody returned. So they thought there is no God. So forget about all these things. People became atheists. So this risky civilization is going on. They don't want to know what is God, neither they want to satisfy. And our Krishna consciousness movement is just the opposite, that here is God, you satisfy. Never mind what you are, but by your occupational duty, you satisfy. That is perfect. This is our Krishna consciousness movement. And this is taught in the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna ultimately said this, sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam. In the beginning he said, yat karosi, yat juhosi, yat asnasi, yat tapasyasi, purushatag madarpana. Do it for me. Yat karosi. It doesn't matter what you are doing. Very good work or bad work or anything. When he says jat karosi, whatever you are doing, do it. But the result, give me. Purushatad madarpanam. This is his desire. And at last again he said that sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam vraja. This is the instruction of Bhagavad Gita. And if somebody would say that simply I have to satisfy you, then I have to satisfy others also. If I do not do, then I'll be sinful. That Krishna says, aham tva sarva pape bhama khoishyami. Masuja. Don't worry. If there is any reaction, not doing other duties simply to surrender to me, and if there is sinful reaction, then I will give you protection. Don't worry. This is the conclusion. And we are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is. That's all. Without any malinterpretation. Everyone is interpreting in his own way. But we are not interpreting. We are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is, and it is becoming effective. Bhagavad Gita was studied in the Western country since a long time, since 17th century. But not like this. Before me, many Swamis, yogis, they came to the Western countries and most of them spoke on Bhagavad Gita. But not a single person was a devotee of Krishna. But now they are becoming by hundreds. Because the Bhagavad Gita is presented as it is. This is the comparison. We have got Christians, Mohammedans, then Buddhists, Africans, everyone we have got in our society, all very devout. Executor of our mission. Now here is Mr. Attar. Now he is Atreya Rishi. Whatever he is earning, he is spending for Krishna. Rangsiddhi Haritosanam, he is trying to satisfy Krishna. That is one. So, in the dictionary, it is stated Krishna is a Hindu god. He is not a Hindu god, he is God. But he appeared in India he remained in the Vedic culture. Lord Buddha was also Hindu, and he was in Vedic culture. Later on, he spread his own mission. That is also Hindu culture. Ahimsa, non-violence. Lord Buddha, Keshava Dhrita Buddha, the same Krishna, he is powerful avatar, Lord Buddha. Keshava Dhrita Buddha Sarira Jaya Jagadisha Hare. We offer our prayers to Lord Buddha. Christ was also for 12 years in India. He crashed the word Christ and Christo. There is similarity. He also propagated love of God. There is Krishna. So we are spreading this Krishna consciousness, and you are all Indians. It is your duty to see that the movement is pushed forward. Pranai rathai dhya vacha. By your life, by your money, by your good intelligence, and by your words, our mission is to spread the words of Krishna. We don't manufacture anything. Why should we manufacture? Everything is there perfectly. What Krishna says, it is perfect. If I manufacture something, that is imperfect, because I am imperfect. How can I speak perfectly? Or how can I give perfect knowledge? It is not possible, because I am defective. I commit mistake. I am sometimes illusion. Why sometimes? Practically always. Everyone is thinking that he is this body. He is Indian, he is American, he is Hindu, he is Muslim. That is illusion. He is not this body. Similarly, our senses are imperfect. And so long we are in the imperfect condition, if we teach, that means we cheat. I have no perfect knowledge, and still I am trying to teach. That is cheating. Nobody should try to preach with imperfect knowledge. That is cheating. That is stated in the Shastra, Bhram, Pramad, Vipralisha, and Karunapata. We are qualified with these imperfections. Therefore, we cannot manufacture. Somebody says, in my opinion. What is the value of your opinion? You are imperfect. If the child says, in my opinion, what is the value? Therefore, we don't say, in my opinion, our opinion. We say, Krishna says this. That's Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission is, he says, Amar Agnay Guru Haiya Tara Ei Desh. Jare dakho tare kaho Krishna upadesh. He says, that all of you, you become guru. Just like I am requesting all Indians outside that I am alone trying to spread this Indian culture. Why not you also join? He also become guru. Well, how to become guru? Not that simply by advertising that one has become guru all of a sudden. No. Guru means, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, jare dakho tare kaho Krishna upadesh. Whomever you meet, you just instruct him what Krishna has said. That's how you become guru. It is not very difficult to become guru, provided we simply preach the instruction of Krishna. That you agree. We do not say that we are perfect, we have become God, or we have so many magic jugglery. No, we have nothing to do that. No magic, no jugglery, no God. Simply to become servant of God. And whomever we meet, we speak the words of God. Then you become guru. This is our mission, that we may be imperfect, that doesn't matter. We are imperfect. Just like this child is imperfect, everyone knows. But if he says, my father has informed me that this is microphone. So this knowledge of his microphone is perfect. Because he received from the father, experienced father. Before hearing from the father, he may not know that this is microphone. But since he has heard from the father that this is microphone, and if he says to others that my father has said this is microphone, then people will accept this is perfect knowledge. So we should follow this instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jare dakho tare kaho Krishna upadesh. So you, every one of you can become guru. Oh. You may say that I'm not interested to become a guru. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, that you are not interested, that is not what we good. You should be interested. You must be guru. That is success of your life. You can speak the instruction of Krishna even to your family. That also guru. You are actually guru, the father, or the head of the family is guru to the children, to the wife. In India still, the wife addresses the husband as Pati Guru. And father is guru, that is natural. So why don't you become real guru to your wife, to your children, and instruct Bhagavad Gita as it is. This is our mission. You sit down in the evening, chant Hare Krishna mantra, and teach little instruction from the Bhagavad Gita. See how the life changes. Is a very difficult task. Bali?
No.
So do that. Don't approach the cheater guru, bluffer guru, and be cheated. Stop this business. This has spoiled the whole spiritual atmosphere of the world. Take Guru, the Supreme Guru, Krishna. Krishna, in Mahabharata, when Maharaj Yudhishthira performed Rajasya Yajna, in the Rajasya Yajna, one person is elected the chief guest. So in that yajna, many big demigods were present, and Bhishma Dev was present, Vyas Dev was present, and many other saintly person, Brahman from the whole universe were present, and Krishna was decided to be accepted as the. Everyone agreed to accept him as the chief guest. And the Shishupal, he protested. Then everyone was angry to kill him. So Krishna is accepted, the Guru, by everyone. By our acharyas, recent acharyas, Ramanucharya, Madhvacharya. I am not speaking of the lower class, but those who are recognized acharyas, Shankaracharya, they accepted Krishna as the Supreme Guru, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So accept Krishna as the Supreme Guru and follow his instruction and try to convince others. Others means even if your family member. That is like success of life. Saṃsiddhi haritosana. Why should you lead your life blindly? This human life is meant for enlightenment, supreme enlightenment. And this is supreme enlightenment. To understand the teachings of Bhagavad Gita and preach it as far as you can. If not, you can preach amongst your family members. This is perfection of life. What is that verse? Jayamam paramam guhyam madhvakti sevidasyati. That is the desire of Krishna.
Ya idam paramam guhyam mad bhakteshu abhidhashati bhaktim mayi param kritva mame vaishati asangshayaha. For one who explains this supreme secret to the devotees, devotional service is guaranteed, and at the end he will come to he will come back to me. Nachatasman manasyeshu kaschin me priyakrit tamaha bhavita nachame tasmad anyak priyataro bhuvi. There is no servant in this world more dear to me than he, nor will there ever be anyone more dear.
So this is the easiest process, that you learn Bhagavad Gita, don't misinterpret. There is no question of misinterpretation. They, by their crippled mind, they misinterpret. Otherwise, there is no question of. Where is it difficult to understand? So, Krishna says, anyone who preaches this Krishna philosophy, he is my dearmost person. So if you are recognized by Krishna, then that is saṃsiddhi harito janam. That is what. Balia, any question? No question? Tadvidhi paripate na paripustya na sevaya. That must be paripustya. Yes and no.
When the question was the satisfaction of the God, we satisfy our Lord. Now, what are the means to satisfy the Lord?
That he says, that you preach, you become guru. That is already explained. Jai idam paramanguyam mad bhakti so vidhar. That is, he says, manvana bhava mad bhakta madhyaji mag namaskar. Everything is there. What is the difficulty? If I say that you do this, I will satisfy. You do that, you will satisfy. What is the difficulty?
Another part where you said to preach Krishna's, to attain the satisfaction for that. But what you have already said, one should first know himself, first correctly the basic.
Himself?
What Krishna stands and what Krishna means in the Bhagavad Gita.
That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita.
Yes.
Why don't you?
We say we start preaching. So first one somebody has to know himself.
Yeah.
Then he can come forward for preaching.
So why don't you know yourself? Why you are in darkness? Krishna says everything in the Bhagavad Gita. In the beginning, he says, Dehi nasmin yatha dehi, kaumaraju. In this body, there is the occupier of the body. So if you think yourself that you are this body, that is your wrong. You try to understand that I'm not this body. I'm spirit soul, aham brahmasmi. That's the fact. So, this human life is meant for that purpose. So why should you not do it? Why should you keep yourself in darkness? That is very risky. if I keep myself in the darkness, like cats and dogs, that I am this body, then my life is very risky. By nature's way, we are given this opportunity, human form of life. If you do not understand our position, if you remain in the same category, bodily concept of life, then we are missing the chance. After all, you have to change this body. It is not permanent settlement that you shall remain Indian, you shall remain American. No. Tatha dehantara prapti, you have to change. Now what kind of body you are going to get, that you have to understand. That is responsibility. That this child, this boy, if he remains in darkness, that he'll continue this childhood body and father and mother will take care of him. I don't require to take any education. Then future life, when he'll be a young man, he'll be not nicely posted for want of education, then how miserable it will be. Similarly, if you don't take care of this education, that I am not this body, my future body will be different. And if I do not know what kind of different body I will have to accept, suppose we accept some lower grade of body, then what is my future? So if you don't understand this philosophy, as Krishna teaches, asmin dehe dehina, within this body there is the occupier, soul. So if you do not understand, that is very risky life. Nature's way must go on. Prakriti kriyamanani, gunai karmani sarva. We cannot control over the nature's way. And we get our next body according to the association of different modes of nature. Karanam gunasangas. Everything is there. Why do you not study? Why do we remain in darkness? What is this life? Is that very good life? What is your name?
No, it's not.
Sahani.
Mr. Sahani.
Sahani, yes. Mr. Sahani, do you think is that very nice life? To remain in darkness for our future life?
Not at all.
That's it. Keval dandavat karte ro. That is very good. That is our process. Sankha purvaka nama gana nativhi. The Vaishnavas, they chanted with a numerical strength, sankha purvaka. Sankha purvaka nama gana nativhi. Nama means chanting of the holy name. Gana means also prayer and also dandavat. Raghunath Das Goswami, he took vow that so many times I will offer dandavat. So these things are. If this child simply offers dandavat to the Vaishnava or Vishnu, so it will not go in vain. Even if he does not know any shastra, simply offers obeisance, that will also be taken into credit. It is so nice thing. Sankha purvaka namagana nativi kala vasani krita. So therefore deity worship is recommended, that if anyone does not know anything, if he simply comes and offers obeisance, that will not. Therefore deity worship is important for the common man. Even if he does not know anything, if he simply comes and offers obeisance, if he little dances with kirtan, everything will be taken into credit. Then one day he'll become a devotee. Bhavanam janmanamante jnanavan maṁ prabhadyate. The jnanavan, the so-called jnanavan, they do not care for the deity. Pop-top. But Krishna says, this class of jnanavan, after many, many births, when he will be actually jnanavan, he will offer obeisance. Vasudeva sarvamiti, samahatma sudurlava. It is so difficult and easy. A jnanavan, after many, many births, come to this conclusion, here is Vasudeva sarvamiti. I offer my obeisance. And the same obeisances can be offered by a child without being jnanavan, but the result is the same. If you touch fire after studying the physics and chemistry, and without studying physics and chemistry, if you touch fire, the result is the same. So our request to everyone is not to keep oneself in darkness and spoil the boon of human life, but try to understand your position and try to understand how to satisfy the Supreme. Everything is there in the Bhagavad Gita. That is the summary of all Vedic literature. This is our Krishna consciousness movement. And if you try to preach, then you become most recognized person of Krishna. Nachatasmat manusheshu kaschit nishya. And our mission is to satisfy Krishna, saṃsiddhi haritosanam. And he says, in this way I become most satisfied. Then, where is the difficulty?
Krishna consciousness movement, is there any different methods?
No, method I have all explained. Krishna bhakti means do what Krishna says. That is Krishna bhakti. Anukulyena Krishna anusilanam, just like Arjuna did. He did not like to fight with his cousin brothers. But after hearing instruction of Krishna, he said, yes, nashta moha, my illusion is now over. Sthir labdha, I've got my consciousness. Karishye vachanam tam. I shall act as you are saying. Yes. This is it. We may have different decisions. That is natural. But when you agree to abide by the orders of Krishna, then your life is perfect. That is Krishna consciousness. So you have to agree. Krishna does not force. He says, do this, like this. And if we agree, then we have Krishna consciousness.
You satisfy equally in whatever yes. path you choose?
Yes. The satisfaction is the point. So, just like the head of the family, he's asking his wife to do something, children to do something, servant to do something. So, if they're doing according to the order, then it's very nice. The head of the family is satisfied and everything is going nicely. Anywhere, in office also, there are different officers, secretaries, managers, and the director, he has given, you do this, you do that, you do that, you do that. So if they do their duty, then everything is nice. Just like in your body, here also you have got different parts. The hand does something, the leg something, the belly something, the brain something. What the brain does, the leg does not do. But the leg is doing for the satisfaction of the whole body. The brain is doing for the satisfaction of the whole body. Hand is doing for the satisfaction of the whole body. That is equal. Not that what is brain doing, the leg has to do this. The leg may do his own way, but the aim is satisfaction of the order of the... I ask the leg, please take me from this room to that room. That is leg's duty. I am satisfied. So not that Krishna is only one-sided. That they do not understand. Krishna is the Ishvara, controller of the whole creation. So if he gives you something to do for his satisfaction, you do that. It does not matter whether you are doing the same thing, the same example. Leg is doing something else than the hand. Hand is doing something else than the brain. But the real purpose is to satisfy the whole. So, Krishna is not asking Vyasadeva to come and fight in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. Vyasadeva is doing his own work. He's writing literature, Vedavyasa. And asking Arjuna to fight. But although the activities are different, Vyasadeva is writing Vedanta Sutra and Arjuna is fighting, but both of them are equally important. Krishna says, Arjuna, Bhaktosi, you are my very dear friend, and Priyosi. Therefore I shall speak to you about this Bhagavad Gita. Krishna did not say, call Vyasadeva, I have to speak Bhagavad Gita. He's a learned scholar. No. Arjuna was not a learned scholar, he was a warrior. And he was a grihastha, busy in politics. Still, he called Arjuna, yes, I shall speak to you, Bhagavad Gita. Why? Bhaktosi, you are my devotee. So to become devotee, it doesn't require that one has to become a very big scholar or very rich man. No. Simply, he has to agree, yes, sir, what you say, I shall do. That's all. This is bhakti. To become bhakta is not a very difficult thing. You simply agree. Krishna, what you say, I shall do. That's all. Karishye vachanam tava. That is perfection. So Krishna wants this. This is the common formula for all. Jaidam paramam goyam madhukti sovidasa. Anyone who speaks about this Bhagavad Gita, Sarvadharma, he is very dear to me. So agree to that proposal. That we shall speak to everyone about this Bhagavad Gita as Krishna has spoken. Then you become a bhakta. That's all. You can do it in your office, you can do it in your home. Krishna does not say that first of all you become a sannyasi and you change your dress and become like this Krishna conscious man. No. You remain in your position. But do this. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sane sthita sutigatam tanuvang manovi. You remain in your place. Sane sthita. Simply he hear from Krishna or from Krishna's representative and do it. That's all. Where is the difficulty? Well, it is my request that you are so many respectable Indian gentlemen here and we are preaching Krishna's message. You come forward, you learn more, and join this mission. It is not meant for Mr. Attar. It is meant for everyone, especially for the Indians. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that also. Bharat bhumite manusya janma hoilo ja. Bharat bhumite means in the land of Bharatvasa. Bharat bhumi is considered punna bhumi. So you are fortunate that you have taken birth as a human being in India. It is the result of much pious activities. Indians are naturally Krishna conscious. Now, this gentleman, Mr. George, what is his name, full name? The Canadian ambassador. He came to see me. He saw me in Delhi when our function was going on. You are speaking, you are so surprised. So this moment has got good potency and every one of you join. Bharat bhumite manusya janma hoilo ja. Janma sarthak kori karo paropokar. This is paropokar. The whole world is in darkness without Krishna consciousness. So enlightened. Paropokar. Human life is paropokar, it is not animal life. To do good to others. Cats and dogs, they are selfish. But human life should be paropokar. So this is the biggest Paropakara movement. And it is very easy to take part in it. You don't require to be very expert. Everything is there. You simply carry the message like pure. Krishna says this, kindly follow. That's all. We don't say that I say this, I manufactured this. I have become a very big man, God. We don't say nonsense. This is all nonsense. Simply carry message of Krishna, then you are perfect. In the Western countries, they are little fond of yoga. So the yoga system is also spoken by Krishna in the 6th chapter. But the conclusion is, when Arjuna refused, my dear Krishna, it is not possible for me. This meditation, this pranayama, and dhyan dharana, jam niyam dhyan, it is not possible. I am a politician. I have no time either. He said frankly. Then Krishna satisfied him that you are already the best of the yogis. Yogi nama pi sarve sam madgata antaratmana sadhyavan bhajati juma sami yuktatama. You are already yogi, first class yogi, because you are always thinking of me. So this is the standard of first class yogi, to remain always in Krishna consciousness and try to execute his will. That's all. That is first class yogi. Krishna says, you haven't got to get certificate from anyone else. Krishna says, yogi nama pi sarvesam madgata antaratmana. He's always thinking of Krishna, antaratmana. That is real yoga. Yoga means dhyanavastita tadgatena manasa pasyantijam yogina. One who is always thinking of Krishna by dhyana, by meditation, that is real yoga. And Krishna says also, this, confirms this, says that madgata antaratmana saddhavan bhajati jumaan sami yuktatam. That is first class yoga. This bodily exercise is meant for person who is in the bodily concept of life. One who understands that I am not this body, I am part and parcel of Krishna. My duty is to serve Krishna. And that is first class yoga. So become first-class yogi, first-class recognized person by Krishna, make your life success. That is Krishna consciousness movement. So what was your question? Yes? Yes, question. You question something.
It's just, it's people, for example, could the president of the Coca-Cola company
find the way to Krishna, mm-hmm. serve Krishna.
Yes, everyone can serve. Cola company?
Coca-Cola
company.
Huh?
Coca-Cola.
Coca-Cola.
A company that manufactures a product which is basically destructive.
Mm. No. Coca-Cola company, of course, we advise. Krishna advises. Jat Karosi. It includes Coca-Cola company. But he says Jat Karosi. Whatever you do. Krishna said, whatever you do. So that includes all kinds of activities. But will the Coca-Cola company agree to give the profit to Krishna? Then he is Krishna conscious. The prophet will enjoy for his wine and woman, that's all. Not for Krishna. That is the dividend.
Can the profit of the manufacturer, something which is manufactured purely for profit, be turned to good?
Yes, if he gives to Krishna. No. Just like Arjuna, he fought, he killed. Killing is not good business. But he killed on the advice of Krishna. And he became a bhakta by killing. Krishna said, bhaktoshi. And what did he do? He killed. That's all. This is an example. Of course, bhakta never kills. Krishna, Arjuna was not willing to kill. But when he saw that Krishna wants it, that this is my first business. Never mind, I shall go to hell. That is Krishna consciousness. By killing my brother, I may go to hell, it doesn't matter. But Krishna will be satisfied. That is my first business. Krishna sometimes pretended to be sick. And many physicians came. They could not cure him. Headache. So he suggested that I think if my devotee gives their dust of food on my head, then I'll be cured. Then every devotee was approached, give your dust of feet. Krishna wants it. Even Narada. So Narada said, how it is possible? I shall give my dust of feet to Krishna. No, no, it is not possible. But when the person, messenger approached gopis in Vrindavan, and they are informed that Krishna is sick, so he wanted the dust of feet of the devotee to be applied on his head. Nobody gave it. So we have come last to you. So immediately, yes, yes, take it, take it. Hey. And so much dust was collected. Huh? And Krishna was cured. So this is gopis. Others thought that if I give the dust of my feet to Krishna, I may go to hell. But the gopis thought, let us go to hell, but Krishna, let Krishna be cured. Therefore, the gopis are the first-class devotees. They do not care for themselves. That is recommended by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Ramma kachid upasana brajabadhu bhargavija kalpita. The process of worship, as it was planned by the gopis in Vrindavan, there is no comparison. That is the highest devotion. They did not care for themselves. They simply wanted to satisfy Krishna. When Krishna was playing flute, at dead of night, all the gopis are flying to Krishna. His father husband, where you are going in this day, or where you are going? They didn't care. Society, friends, him, love, all sacrifice. We shall go to Krishna. This is Krishna bhakti. That is the highest perfection of life. To sacrifice everything for Krishna. Only Krishna should be satisfied. That is Krishna bhakti. That is not very easy job, but one can do if he likes everything for Krishna. Krishna says also, sarva dharman parityajya. Gopis did not care for social, for religious, or family, and nothing. Sarva dharman parityajya. They went, Krishna now is calling. Let us go. This is the typical example of sarva dharman parityajya, mam ekam saranam. So of course it is not possible to become on the standard of gopis, that is not possible. But at least we shall try to follow these devotees. Arjuna is there, gopis are there, Uddhavas are there, many devotees. Lord Brahma is there, Lord Shiva is there, Kapil Dev is there, the four Kumaras are there, Bhishma Dev is there, Prahlad Maharaj is there, Janak Maharaj is there, Sukhdev Goswami is there. So, Mahajana Jina Gatasya Pantha, if you simply follow these big, big devotees, then our life is successful. For authorized person's name to follow them. Sambhu, Narada Sambhu, Kumara, Kapila, Manu, Prahlada, Bhishma, Janaka, Bali, Bhaiya, Sakhi, Bayam. 12. Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, Narad, then the four Kumaras, then Kapil Dev, then Prahlad Maharaj, Bhishma, Janak Maharaj, Vyasadev, Vyasaki, son of Vyasadev, not Vyasadev, son of Vyasadev, Sukhdev Goswami, Bali Maharaj, and Jamraj, these 12 Mahajan, we can follow them. Sarvatma Sapane, Bali. Bali Maharaj gave everything to Krishna.